What's up, guys? It's Paladin Null and my friend CPQ.
Hi.
And we're playing a new one today. So for those who've been paying attention, we just finished the live stream for Final Fantasy X, I believe, on what, Thursday?
Yes, Thursday.
We finished it on Thursday because I played Don't Starve on Saturday.
Yeah.
So it's Tuesday now for those watching on YouTube, and JRPG is done for now. We've still got a thing open for the new JRPG, and it's going to be open throughout the rest of this game. But this is Giga Wrecker by Game Freak, the people that make or help make.
You have my hair all over you. I'm sorry.
The people that make or help make the Pokemon series. But we're just going to start the game with a brand new game. March 20th, 2032. Those things suddenly appeared. Unidentified killing machines. Where they came from, how they got here. Everyone came up with their own ideas, delusions, and theories. Secret weapons of some country went out of control. Maybe they're drones sent by aliens from outer space. They must be metallic life forms from another dimension. Artifacts from some ancient civilization. Conspiracy theories were even headlined on TV and newspapers, but all those only lasted for a few days. As the invasion advanced much faster than we could think, and cities disappeared one after another from our maps, nobody was making stupid rumors anymore. Our armies didn't have a chance against their unknown technologies. All they could do was fall back and retreat. 3 years passed since then.
That's some cool artwork.
Those who are left are barely living in this hell on earth, hiding inside ruins, crawling around like rats. Once you get caught, the old and sick will be killed. The young will be made slaves and worked to death. Here sits a girl in captivity. A girl who lost her family, friends, and everything. Her name is Reika Rikeiji. What a screw up. These 3 years, somehow I managed to survive. Bad situations many times, but this time I guess it's over. 19 years, such a short life. And standing in a ruined town close to the prison is another young girl.
I must find her, whatever it takes. I feel like she needs a much cuter voice than that. Like a much higher voice.
Than what I can offer?
No, than what I just did. I feel like she needs a higher voice than that.
Well, now we're playing her.
I'm going to try to be... Yeah. Like that.
So all the voices in this game are going to be in Japanese. But there's no Japanese voice acting. There's just text.
Oh,
but like every now and again they say things. And what they say is usually...
important.
No, it's usually just Japanese.
This prison must be down here. That's not good enough. Gotta make it better. The door is locked. There must be a console somewhere to unlock it. Hmm. I think that was it.
There you go.
Oh, so you can drop through the metal ones.
Yes, if you hold down and hit A, you drop.
Okay. That's it. The console to unlock that door. Oh, it's so cute. Hooray for me!
I've only played a little bit of this so far, just to make sure that worked.
Reika! You must be here!
Thump. Clink. Clank.
Oh! Thud. Okay. Reika! Reika! I don't think that's even correct. What is her name?
Who is it? It's Reika.
Okay.
Someone from a rescue squad?
Good! You're still safe!
Thanks. What? Wait a minute. Why do you know my name?
Intruder. Intruder.
An alarm?
Unregistered organism detected in prison. Security squad must head to location immediately.
Guess they found me. I don't think we'll be able to get out of here together.
Huh? What do you mean?
There's no other choice now. I must...
Wait. Put that thing down. It's dangerous. You'll hurt yourself.
You are a kind person. But that kindness will cause the extinction of the whole human race.
What are you talking about?
So, I must kill you here.
No, wait. Stop. Stop!
Intruder detected. We have captured an unregistered human in prison section. A juvenile female, decided suitable as subject. Repeat, we have captured a human subject.
No! Let me go! I haven't finished my job yet!
Wait, did she shoot us?
I don't know. I don't think so.
I think she did shoot us.
Okay.
I was injured heavily and lost consciousness.
Well, we are the white girl right now, so... Hmm? We're the white-haired girl right now.
Spoiler alert, we're gonna play as her, like the rest of the game.
Oh.
Well, what a spectacle. Your left arm is gone from the shoulder. Your ribs have punctured your heart. Your life will end in about 5 minutes, I guess. But I have the ability to save you. So, how about it? When I was fading away, I agreed with his offer. This man, Dr. Kozuki, became a guinea pig for his studies in exchange for bringing me back to life. Kozuki is a mad scientist. No other choice but to rely on him. In order to save my life, my body is reborn in exchange with my pride. With body and arm stronger than original, I became a cyborg, half machine, half human. My name is Reika Rikeiji. Hey! Hello there, you listening girl? What's up? Having a dream? No, just forget it. Well, looks like your communication functions are working fine. Okay, let's make things clear. What you want from me, and I want from you. I want you to collect and send me as much data as you can. You want me to get you out of this hellhole as soon as possible. That's right. I want to spend my new life out of here. Also, I've got something that's on my mind. Something on your mind? It's none of your business. In case you forget it, you owe me your life. Don't you think you should show a little bit more respect? I know it, but listen up. I got a plan that'll satisfy both you and me.
Roll Tide.
You will search around this place to collect and send me all the data. As soon as I'm happy with it, you're free to go. Free, right. There's no such thing as that in this world. Don't think of it too seriously. It's just like a part-time job. No other choices. All right, I'm in. Yes, that's a good girl. Let's get started.
I really feel like she needs to be voice acted by Brina Palencia.
I have no clue who that is.
One of my favorite female voice actors.
What other work has she done?
Do you remember that first episode of Black Butler you watched?
Yes.
She was the boy.
The small boy?
Yes.
Okay.
The blue-haired boy.
I watched Subs.
Oh. Damn. Well, she sounds really similar to the person that actually did the Japanese one. They did really good with that one.
Okay. A wall. Are you already at a dead end? Of course not. No need to worry. Now's a good time. Let me introduce you to your new powers. The magnificent ultimate invention of all time. One beyond human. The power of the cyborg. Magnificent. I don't think that word, I don't think that's the word to describe all this mess you've done to my body. Hey, don't accuse me, girl. You gave me permission. Well, you might not remember though, because you were that close to death at that point.
You were that close.
Of course. Let's get back to the subject about your new powers. Create an electro wave from your amplified brainwaves and bioelectricity. Excites the nanomachines that exist in the soil and atmosphere. By adding moments to the assembled crystals and this, blah, blah, blah. So if I summarize it all, it means you can just bash through those walls. Got it. Not really how sure all this works, but I'll do this! So this is a cool thing. You can actually... You want to just keep destroying stuff.
That's pretty cool.
But if you want, you can also hop on those things. Wait, that's a class Raga.
Raga.
Raga, I think, is actually how it's pronounced. With the little line over it is to show that it's a long A. They seem to be labor robots, but are still deadly against humans. How could I forget? They slaughtered so many of us. Even my friends. Humans are powerless against them. You are a cyborg, so you have the power to beat them. Just finish the job, get home, and go get me some combat data. You're right. They're no match for me. I can feel it. I have the power to prove it. The power to fight against all this unfair violence. I'm thankful that you gave me this ability. Well, just a little. But keep in mind, being a cyborg means strong, but not invincible. Smack.
Oh, okay.
Okay, I'm getting used to this. I think I can control the direction of my attacks. Bam. Bam. Bam.
Cool.
What's with that wall? There's some kind of yellow stain on it. Those are nanomachines in liquid form.
So you mean piss.
You recall them, you can collect objects stained with them. Recall? You can draw nanomachines along with the debris by directing them with electrowaves. You can pick up stuff too big.
You can't pick up stuff too big.
To crush them into pieces before doing it. Smack. Whoop. Smack.
Whoop. That's really cool. Shit, that's cool as hell.
Big ass ball. Smack. Whoop.
Just in case.
Yeah. The nanomachine's crystallization effect, you can keep and use the recalled debris. A single mass. The more you collect debris, the bigger it'll grow.
Cool.
If I can just hit that button as much as I want. Yeah. Oh, right, there's enemies there. Yeah. You may already know this, but you can recall and collect those robots' corpses, destroying them. That's because nanomachines flow through their body, just like blood inside humans.
Fun. Dave?
Yep, that's the save point.
Cool. What'd that sign say?
It just tells you that this is the save point.
Oh.
I can read it. She doesn't understand why it says it's a save point. I can't understand any of these terms and formulas. Record one's memories at particle data? A save point? Ensure the room is brightly lit? Make sure to take a break frequently? What are you talking about? Those are like the things that they constantly have to tell you nowadays on stuff like that.
Oh, will it fit? Oh, it'll fit. Uh-oh.
What are these? Those are nanocrystals. It's the inert and dormant form of nanomachines. They are ones of materials which form your new body. So if you collect them, I'll use them to upgrade your cyborg abilities. Designed to fight and secure resources at the same time, no one else can make such a masterpiece like this. I say so myself. Whatever it is, I guess it won't hurt to collect them.
Neato. I feel like if that guy continues to be a recurring character, you should let me be her.
Okay.
Yeet.
What's this? Smash.
That's awesome.
And look, the nanomachines cut like the hitting it with it.
Oh. Okay.
Oh, it's because that's not big enough. There we go. But look, killing him there meant that his nanomachine blood splattered all over those rocks.
Which means if you break those, you can keep it.
Hmm.
If you break that part, you can keep it, right?
Yes, but I've already got a full-size ball.
Okay.
When you break walls and pillars, they become heaps of debris, right? Jump on them as footing, so make use of them and explore this place. Sometimes destruction shall create new paths. Sounds like a wise saying, doesn't it?
It does.
You can go ahead and
break and create footing. Right. What happens if I do it too much and destroy destroy the stuff which I shouldn't have?
That's where you should use the singularity point.
I decided to go with Brina Palencia. I'm sorry. A singularity point? What's that?
See the spot where the pink particles are floating from the ground? That's the singularity point. It's where the tachyon particles exist, which warp time and space. By interfering with tachyon field, your electrowave stimulation ability can use a tachyon burst, which will rewind time.
Rewind time? You make it sound so simple.
So let's see here. I actually want to break apart all of this stuff really quick, including this right here, because there's blue stuff in it. But all of a sudden, oh no, I actually can't get any higher up. So these little purple gates are the tachyon bursts. I can do this, but all of a sudden, I don't have my ball anymore, because my ball wasn't in this universe. That's fine, because I can still do this.
That's so fucking cool.
So this game is primarily based on puzzles. This is talking caution. There are reports of tachyon particles generated in the area. Due to the particles being unstable, unnecessary use of electric devices are prohibited. Ah, I think I needed that to land up there. Yeah, to finish this puzzle, I need to get the very top bit of this. There we go.
Awesome.
I need to push that over there so I can reach up here. Let's turn this on. Unlock the door. And now these things are covered in alien blood or robot blood. So I can recall them to make my big old ball. And then I want to destroy everything because I want to collect all the bits out of these rocks. Now I'm free to go.
Nice.
But I think leaving the area means I lose my ball. Yeah,
it does.
Let's see.
Oh, right, what's this? A nano machine lift?
The transport device using liquid nanomachines. Just like an elevator. Reacts with the radio wave of recall and lifts up the platform by spouting nanomachines. Activate it by jumping on and off you go flying. Even heavy girls like you.
Wait a minute! I don't weigh that much, do I?
The metal alloy that forms your new arm and bones, they're much heavier than you think.
I see.
Whee! Whee!
That's pretty cool. I think you have to
I didn't realize I was rocking that as back and forth as much as I was. Smack.
Nice. Oh, you destroyed it.
I got some stuff, though.
Okay, cool.
What's up, girl?
I can grow my debris by recalling. I understand that, but what's the point of doing that?
There are mainly two advantages. First one, it increases your attack range. The bigger you go up the debris ball, the further you can reach with your debris attack. Second, you should find out soon.
Find out soon. Alrighty then.
I can't quite reach that. I was hoping to. Whoops. Come on.
Just collect some of that stuff over there. You'll have a larger attack range.
Let's unlock the door first. I don't think I'm gonna be able to reach that. I'll just smash this. We got a full-size ball now, so let's see if I can't reach that now. Barely not. Oh well.
But it doesn't take it with you.
Meh.
We were just doing this for points.
I make the ball big. Well, let's see here. That's a class Padma. Things have a shield part, which make things a little difficult.
A shield part?
That red and round thing on their head. It's a special structure that absorbs damage.
What do you mean? You're saying it's invincible?
Calm down and listen. There are limits with their durability. You hit them with a debris ball larger than the size of their shield part, you can destroy it, leaving them vulnerable. This is the other advantage of for keeping a large debris ball.
Alright, hit them with a bigger debris ball. Simple enough. Okay then. I'm gonna teach you crude AIs a new program. There's just why is it on multiple lines?
I'm gonna teach you crude AIs a new program from now.
The humiliation of defeat and the fear of death. I don't know what I'm doing. Smack at a fish.
Yeah. Smack at the death bots. Maybe it's about time. I got some cool news, girl.
What?
About your nanomachine ability. It has another function you can use.
Another function?
Arms creating and handling effect. Call it Archie or Arc. I'm gonna go with Arc. Arc sounds cooler. Arc. It's an ability to create weapons and gadgets by decomposing and reconstructing nanomachines and fragments. This function should help you out with fighting those robots. Even getting you out of here.
Well, why can't I use them right now?
There are some limits for creating and using Arc. One must know the complete structure to create and use a weapon.
What? I never learned anything about making weapons.
No worries, you're going to learn them now. This place is a depository of some kind. There must be some blueprint data of weapons. Look for a data terminal with these information, and just install them directly into your brain. Okay then.
Install what? Into my brain? Directly?
No response. You might have already noticed, but I made some enhancements with your eyes. Now you can see the debris attack is stronger than the enemy's shield or not, by the color of the aura glowing on it. The enemy shield part is glowing red, your attacks won't work. If it's glowing blue, you can destroy it.
I understand that it's more convenient, but what are you doing to my body?
Smack of the fish.
Yep. Ah!
Smack of the fish. Smack of the fish.
Neato.
Now I've got like this massive fuck off ball.
That is fucking amazing, holy shit.
Looks like a blueprint data is inside that console. Check it out, girl.
Alright. Check it out, girl.
Installing ability program. Debris lock. Looks like you got a weapon data.
Ugh, my eyes are flashing.
By applying an ARC protocol to the nanomachines, you now have the ability to create the debris lock.
The debris lock?
The ability to form your debris into cubes. You can jump on and then use as platforms.
Were we reading it wrong?
No.
No, it is debris lock, not debris lock.
Not debris block, yeah, no. It's debris lock. But yeah. So this is as far as I've gotten in the game. I played up to here, realized just how fucking cool the mechanics of this game were, and knew I wanted to stream it. So everything from here on out is new to me as well.
Cool.
By the way, I got a gizmo which may help you on your way. The navigation map, an exploration assisting device. Roughly scans the terrain around you by sending weak electro waves to the nanomachines in the atmosphere. One may call it a nanomachine radar.
I see. A really poor sense of direction, so this will help.
You and me both, sister. Okay, I'll give you a slight briefing, so turn it on.
Alright.
This is where you are now, girl.
Wow, this is an enormous place. I can see icons of doors connecting each area, but the places which I haven't gone yet aren't drawn here yet. Aren't there any details of them?
The basic method of research is fieldwork. to walk through doors and check things by yourself. You check locked doors or other important gadgets. Those will be recorded in the navigation map, too. And they will be displayed as icons.
Yeah, I see. So even if doors or machines aren't usable first, I can mark them and keep their locations when I want to come back and try again. If there's anything interesting, always keep their records right.
Well, use it just the way you like. Navigation map can be activated from the pause menu by pressing the start button. Or you can directly activate it if you press the back button.
Ooh, he got it!
I didn't quite make it up that time.
Whoa. What is this?
Let me see. Well. Amazing. Not only recording information, this thing works as a save point and as a warping function at the same time.
Save? Warp?
From now on, you're going to move around and explore a lot of places. If something goes wrong, you can use this to come back here. Or to move somewhere else. Where there's another of these things. Your exploration will be much more easier if you use these as the base of your adventure.
Great. That's convenient.
It works as a marker, so maybe we should call it a beacon. Activating the beacon. Beacon activated. You can warp between activated beacons on the navigation map.
Cool.
Make progress? Yes. So I can head up there, but I can also head down.
Cool.
So I could go through that door right there. Let's see. Accidentally activated the thing. I keep hitting recall.
Yep.
Ah.
So I can head up here. Smash.
Nice. Oh, there's another.
So I don't know who that girl. Oh, that's you.
I don't know who that girl was.
You really don't know her? Can't believe someone risked herself sneaking into a prison and try to kill the person who she just met for the first time.
To begin with, I don't know anyone who might have any reason trying to take my life.
Who knows? Maybe you're a kind of person who makes enemies without realizing.
No way. I thought she came to help me, but all of a sudden she says I should die for the human race. I don't get it.
You are a kind person! Where the fuck does she come from? But all that kindness will cause the extinction of the whole human race!
It just doesn't make sense. But her eyes were serious, and the thoughtful look on her face? They just stick in my mind, I guess.
Mm-hmm. You're really gone on her.
I just want to know the reason why she did that. Wish I could see her again and talk with her.
You gonna look for her? Did she get caught by those robots?
I know, but unless I meet her again, it'll keep staying in my mind.
Where else can I travel right now? I seem to have several doors that I can go through in this area. Let's see here. So if I take the one at the bottom, I'll head here.
Okay.
If I take the one to the left, I'll head here. If I take the one up, I'll go there. But the objective is going to be to the right over here.
Okay.
Which is going to be...
Do you know where higher to go?
No.
Oh.
So the door right here is to the objective, but there's three other doors that we could go to right now as well.
What do you want to do? You set up a beacon, you can come back later.
Let's go to the objective and see what it is, because I have a feeling we're going to end up exploring those other rooms at some point anyway.
Yeah. Wait, you seriously think I can go up against them? I've seen those before. They were ripping cars in half.
The class chakram. Indeed, they do have a bigger shield part, which means stronger defense. And nastier attacks. But you still have a chance of beating them. Match the timing of your debris attack with their tail swing, so you can break it off and use it to increase the size of your debris ball. Believe in your powers. Or I should say, believe in the technology and the theory of the genius who modified your body.
You get on my nerves. But you're right. We came this far, there's no turning back now. Okay, let's do it. Now it's their turn to be ripped apart.
Okay, that's cool. So you have to time your attacks.
Yeah. Yep. That is awesome.
Whoa.
Whoa, that's a lot of debris. These locks, they're quite heavy. They're quite heavy when you drop them. Never thought that nano machines were powerful enough to lift up such heavy stuff. Maybe I can drop these on something and use them as weights.
You know, the obvious puzzle ahead of us.
Bruh! Yep.
Hey girl, this is something obvious. Imagine looking for someone who caught up by the enemy means you're trying to jump into danger by yourself. Something bad might happen to you. I don't want to risk losing all the combat data.
You're worrying about the data this... You're worrying about the data they and me?
Yeah, the English translation's not maybe the best.
You're worrying more about the data than me?
There you go.
It'll be alright. You gave me this new body and powers. I think I can handle it. And I don't want to keep worries left unsolved. That's much worse. You never know what will happen tomorrow, so we should spend our lives without any regrets, right?
Is that so? Well, don't blame me for any troubles. At least keep the data safe, okay?
Oh, duh. Well. That's horrifying.
Yeah, that's no fun down there. Gee, yikes. How Fudge. The hell? Can I maybe...
Yep.
Let's see here. Oh, damn it. I was hoping I could you could use that as a way to head back up.
Throw it at something and take half of it, maybe.
Well, I'm thinking what I could... Whoops. Come on. So place it here, right? Oh, wow, it's not big enough now.
Oh, shit.
I don't have enough debris.
Anything else?
Maybe tachyon field?
That's gonna get rid of the ball though, isn't it?
But it'll replace everything, which was this giant mass right here, which should be enough to create a lock, a proper lock. Oh, but I'm gonna lose that lock now.
Yep.
Let's make the full size lock. I'm wondering, can I do this really quick? Watch this. Ready? Place it here, right? You have to go down. And as far this way, like, I'm gonna get you halfway, right?
Uh-huh.
Call it back. Have it rock. Rock back up and jump.
Bruh! You did good!
Yeah. Fuck that. That's...
Nice.
I just left a whole bunch of shit up there. Okay.
Okay.
What's this sign?
What's this machine?
That's a warp portal. The robots use this machine for transporting soldiers and rescuers.
A warp portal? A warp portal?
If this thing exists here, that means if you're gonna use this thing, you'll be sent to one of their operation bases. They are much, much more dangerous than here. There's no guarantee of being back in one piece. I warned you there. So, are you ready for this, girl?
Yep. Yeah.
Yeet.
Come on, Rika. You have to find that girl.
So I could go in there. Let's explore. Games like this are all about exploration. Okay, so place the ball on one side to go to the other. Which side should I go up to? I'm thinking I need to go up to that side, so let's place a block here.
Ah, hurry! Be good!
Be cold! That's not big enough.
Maybe you have to put it
all
the
way to the edge, yeah. Yep.
There we go.
There we go. Okay, so I actually had to turn it on as well.
Okay, cool. Oh.
And this is how we get back down, and then we can nab more juice. Oh wow, I tipped that whole thing over. Wow.
Shoo. That's really cool.
Probably gonna lose this ball if I go through this door, though.
Probably, but you can try.
Man. Yeah. I feel like I lose the ball pretty much any time I leave a room.
Yeah.
Which means that each individual room is a puzzle set up for that specific purpose, so yeah. It's probably good that I lose the ball.
That's true. No cheating.
Mm-hmm. But at the same time, it means that they can't set up a puzzle with the express purpose of having a room set up, like, where you had to have come in with another thing.
True.
You got a line.
Oh. This place is so creepy. I have to admit, I'm already starting to regret coming here. To begin with, what is this place?
The whole coastal zone around here used to prosper as an industrial area. But after the robots invaded it, they kept on rebuilding it, and now it's their weapon construction facility. They're going to take you here, force you to work to death.
Then I ran away, almost got killed. Then you saved me. And leads to now.
Smack.
Be good! Be good!
Oh. How about this? Let's get rid of that. And lock. Get a recall.
Cool.
Caution! High important security item. Unauthorized access to a gate key unit is strictly prohibited. I see. When I go deeper into this facility, you must activate a number of these gadgets and unlock the gate security. Oh, this thing is on a pivot. Watch this. Are you ready for this?
No, let's do it.
Whoops, I did not mean to blow up part of the wall. There, see it moving around now?
Yeah.
It's like on a pivot gate.
Oh. Cool. Awesome.
Told you this is going to be a cool game.
This is a pretty cool game. What happened if he just jumped off into that pit?
You'd probably get sent back to the tachyon gate. Oh shit. Yeah. Oh shit.
Oh, oh shit. Fucking shit, though. Oh fuck. Yes!
Bloodsteel Arsony Label member. Class, Mangala. As a round carapace, they bounce around and compress the surface. Class Mangala has a red, red body. Watch out, or he'll crush everybody. Nope. Well, wait for those to turn back on.
Will the fire hurt you?
Yep.
Nah, because they're nanomachine based.
Right. Oh.
I am very hurt right now. I don't know how I get more health back. Yep, I just died.
Shit.
Well, let's figure out where I go when I die. Okay, so I go back to the beginning of the level when I die.
Okay.
Yep.
I got a little bit of something right now. Alright then.
Oh.
Good.
Maybe I can put something into it.
Like a lock?
That's cool. Ooh.
I bet that's a test to see if you have a big enough ball.
god.
Crystal Converters, a masterpiece made by your sweet sweat and tears, can convert certain quantity of debris into nanocrystals. It can only be used once before it is discarded. Okay. Venata. I can't read that. Whatever. Oh, maybe it's about time. How's your crystal collection going?
Not bad, I guess. I remember you telling me that I should collect these. But how do I actually use them?
I got an interface ready, so you can use them by yourself. It's a skill tree. You can unlock these and release your powers or skills by using the crystals which you have collected. Be sure to check out whenever you have the time. Skill trees. So we should have upgrades available. Yep. Let's see here. Vitality chip. 4 chips will increase your maximum health.
Can you only do what's next to you?
Yeah. You can. You have to go down the tree.
Oh, okay.
4 chips will increase your maximum health. What is this up here? Expand the range of your debris attack by holding down the attack button. Effective increases. Grab that. This is auto repair. Regenerate your health gradually. Okay, I like that. And we're out of skill points. So we got,
cool. We got auto repair.
Enough vitality chips to increase our total health. And the caterpillar drive.
Cool.
So let's see what the caterpillar drive is like. That's a regular attack, and then I can do that now.
I can do what now?
See, look at the distance difference.
Oh, yeah. That's pretty cool. Yeah.
Oh,
looks like you can go through it.
I didn't lock that. There was a button to unlock.
Yep.
Head off to the next room, then.
Yay.
Oh, look, a new data terminal. There's the data console. Go and download it.
Yeah, I know.
Installing ability, Debris Blade. Looks like you got a weapon data.
Ugh, what is this? My head is spinning.
By applying an ARC protocol to the nanomachines, you can now have the ability to create the debris blade.
The debris blade.
The ability to form your debris into a sharp sword. You can slice straight through walls and pillars. And I'm getting a call from my father. We will be right back, everybody. Sorry about that. I had a call from my father that I had to take.
So what'd he say about me?
If he knew you were not in...
Oh, no.
Whoa, that's cool.
That's
Smack.
Fucking awesome.
Yep. See, Bledo. See. Sometimes she says Bledo. That's cool.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Whoa.
Okay, that's cool.
Ah.
Yes, Bledo.
Good night, bitch.
Unlock the door.
Cool.
And then bang. Slam.
Yeet.
I love killing those guys that way. Oh!
What?
This entire thing.
Whoa!
Oh, but I have to run fast.
Shit.
Okay.
Oh shit.
So I gotta be quick after I cut it, I have to be quick. I guess I don't need much to do the blade. Yeah, I don't need much to do the blade. That's dangerous.
Oh my goodness.
This is a really fun game.
Oh, yeah.
That looks awesome.
That's pretty cool. That's 100% Samurai Jack shit right there.
Yeah, this game has a very like Samurai Jack dystopia feel.
What a big landslide. I don't think I'll be able to climb over this. If only there were a way to get it back to how it was before it collapsed.
Time mechanics? I look under the beacon. Hey there, girl.
What?
Even if you got something to ask her, is it really necessary to risk your own life to save someone who you didn't even know? Can't understand it.
Hey, Doc.
Yeah?
Those furnaces, they make all the robots, don't they? Those who took away my family, my friends, and my arm.
Right.
They're going to kill more of our people, right?
I assume.
There'll be more lonely kids like me. Kids with no dreams or hope at all. But still couldn't choose to die.
I suppose so. What's your point here?
Yes! Doc, I'm gonna beat him up and destroy this place.
Destroy? Wait a minute. Weren't you telling me you regret coming here?
Yes, I did, and I'm still scared. But now I have the power to defeat them. So I shouldn't run away from this place just because I'm scared or don't like it. It's the same thing, say, to pretend not to see all those kids and their family, lose their family. It's just unfair it should happen. It shouldn't happen. I can't read.
What's that thing's hard?
I can't read. And I can't leave that girl left caught by those... I can't leave that... I fucking am fucking up.
You were right there, too.
I know. And I can't leave that girl left caught by those things.
You should know, even with your powers, it's not an easy thing to accomplish.
I know, but I'll do it.
Well, well. Me, it's a chance to collect some more real and fresh data. And so-called unmixed blessing to me. Okay, go ahead. Take care of yourself. Beacon. You're more between activated beacons on the navigation map. Down here.
I need to record my creepypasta today.
Yep.
Need to release it before Valentine's Day is over.
What's up?
How's the Valentine's Day theme?
Ouch. Okay, well.
Did she just yell baka?
No.
What did she just yell?
I don't know.
Ah, shit.
She just
Nice.
Asshole.
Zzz. What's up? The communication signals are crossing.
Zzz. There is a report for our viceroy, Astra Venata.
Report? This is their communication?
Zip. What is it? Let me hear it. Zzz. Thank you, viceroy. There are huge casualties in our security squads resulting from encounters against an intruder. Zip. An intruder? You'd think those humans have such abilities to fight against us and cause such damage. The intruder. Only one human has been confirmed. One? Only a single human? I'm not just a human. I'm a cyborg.
I don't think they know that yet. Everyone who has seen you has died.
Okay.
Oh god, that's horrifying.
So that teleports me, that brings me back to the front here. Sharp tools, yeah, that's just to tell me, like, hey, cut the line. I gotta find the lock. There isn't a lock to unlock that. Oh wait, hold on, it might be down this way.
Ooh. There we go. Oh, fuck.
I don't care what it was. I was big enough to kill it, so that's good enough for me. Bloodsteel Arsenal Labor Member. Class Ashoka. Sends out her babies to hunt down and incinerate her enemies.
Oh.
Class Biha. Is born to be an explosive device. Victory for their mother. A small sacrifice.
Oh.
That only unlocks this bottom door. I don't even... Oh, it unlocked
this door. Okay, cool. So which door do we want to go through?
We're right here next to this one. Let's go through this one. Actually, you know what? Let's check our map. So we were supposed to be in here.
Right. Have we made it in there, though?
Well, yeah. So I could have gone through a door in there, but I didn't.
Okay.
Because I kind of want to explore the rest of the factory and see what there is to find.
Right. Beacons connect. Okay, yeah. Beacons can send you to other beacons.
Oh, shit! That's a lot!
Properly. Ow, damn it. See, if I can just get rid of one.
Yeah, and then you're golden.
Damn it, I thought I could sort it. To a red door that I can't access yet because I need to unlock the three things.
Right.
I guess that's the final door in this area. Oh, here's one. So that's two of three, but not three of three yet.
Yeah.
But let me adjust myself here.
You weren't in, I'm sorry.
Huh?
You weren't in there?
What do you mean?
In the picture?
No, I wasn't in the picture just fine. I just needed to adjust myself because I was uncomfortable.
Okay.
Oh, hey, look, it left all of my degree here from last time.
That's pretty cool. I expected it to reset.
I think it just leaves all of your stuff everywhere, because, like, I've already finished that room, so it kind of, like...
Yeah.
I can't do anything to those guys right now. Oh, but I can kill one of them like that. And kill the other one. Yeah. It's kind of interesting every time you walk into a new room, because you're just like, oh, shit, I don't have a ball.
Yeah.
Yeet. Oh. Crossing. Sorry, our horse early. We will respectfully receive any and all punishment. Melt into this symbol. Reset our brains, everything. Stop it. I am not blaming you soldiers for this. One thing I should know. Why did it take you so long to find out the situation? That is, we were unable to find out that human was intruding on the facility, not until I actually appeared in front of us. You say, what do you mean by that? Signals detected from the human bodies are the same as the signals from Ajit's. The same as us. Ajit's signal from a human? The human is attaching parts taken from our brother's bodies. Or should I say, it is completely merging with them. Parts of Ajit's inside, it has misguided our ID scanners and let it inside. See, after she had to do. What an insolent and cruel strategy. Deceiving us at Jesus.
These saws are so loud.
They are very, very loud.
I cannot even hear you.
What an insolent and cruel strategy.
If you are sultry with it.
I cannot even.
Much better.
This deed. The pastry ruling this Samsara. I shall punish this human myself.
Much better, yes. Now that I can understand you.
Trying to figure out how this whole thing works.
Well.
Oh, hold on. You know what I can do?
What? Oh. Oh. Crap.
That was
pretty cool. Nice.
That was fun.
That was awesome. Yeah.
Oh wait, hold on. I just realized. I can reset everything.
That's so cool.
So now everything's back in place and I can just move and jump my way across up here.
Yay.
And activate this third thing so I can actually go back to that one beacon that I was at. Sometimes I forget that I have the ability to just destroy stuff on my own without the ball.
Yeah.
See, that ball was there because it was there whenever I left it there.
Yeah.
Let's go this way and go through the...
There's a gem there. If you wanted to go back and destroy
like a blue
it
gem.
Yeah.
You got it!
Oh, I actually have 2 skill points ready.
Neat.
I can get another vitality
chip. Skill points is like every time you get 100 crystals. Or...
Every time the bar, yeah. Every time the bar fills up. So right now, yeah, I've got, oh, okay. I've currently got 2 out of 100 crystals to fill the bar. Why would I need to zoom in on this? Why would I need to zoom that far out?
It probably gets bigger.
Expansion slot. The slot will be this slot will be available after gaining new arc abilities.
Yeah.
So I guess yeah, a lot of this stuff I'm supposed to like get eventually. Looks like everything I have access. I can get a repair chip, which would increase my regeneration speed. I think I'm gonna head for that. There we go.
Yeah.
That's a lot like the Sphere Grid from Final Fantasy.
Yeah, except you can go back freely.
Yeah. That, honestly, most games you can go back freely. It's only Final Fantasy that's a little bit weird by not letting you go back.
Yeah.
I can use the dead corpses of my enemies. That's a big ass block.
Crystal.
There you go. I got access to this room. I don't have enough material to kill anything.
I thought we'd just get out of the way.
Place this block here. It'll blow up on the floor. Jump, grab, kill, fly.
Yeah.
I still don't quite have enough.
Anything past that point to the left?
Just a like a little bit of ground. Yeah, I shouldn't cut that line. Reset. Oh, I just wanted to do that. Okay. There we go. So I can cut a line. But why would I want to cut a line? Well, I can do this.
Maybe they're just there to trick you.
Cut that line. If I cut this line now, this entire thing... swings, I believe.
Except it's connected to the wall.
Where? By this point right here?
Yeah.
I guess. See? Let's do that. Let's head back down then. No, I can jump up there just time like this. I'm just jumping off too early. That's when I jump off too late.
Huh.
Why? Why did...
Oh. Try a block? What?
Yeah, I think I need a block up here.
May I have to destroy that green piece?
Oh, I can take a little bit off at a time.
Oh.
Oh, I think I know what I need to do then. Let's see here. Let's reset.
You still have all the gems after you reset?
Any of the gems that I had before getting to the place that I'm at, yeah.
Okay.
So let's see here. I want to cut that line right there. And then if I have this link out now, break that off now. Ah! Okay, so yeah, I need to destroy those two lines. So let's see here. Because I want this to swing battering ram style over. I need this one cut, and then I need to cut. And now if I take this, that. Yes! Okay,
yay.
Data.
As long as these things operate this factory, the environment gets destroyed. These things do nothing but cause trouble.
Well, I may not have the right idea to say this. This reality of but this is the reality of silence and technology. Someone gains benefit with it, somebody else will hold the short end of the stick. Rather, this world itself works just like that. Not only science.
Huh? What are you trying to say?
I'm saying that nobody who lives in this world has nothing to blame about nobody, including me. You're not gonna say you survived these 3 years without abandoning or sacrificing nobody or nothing, are you?
No, you're right.
Installing ability program, Pixel Blade.
I got a new weapon, Data.
Yes, now you can use a different kind of debris blade. Now listen, I added a new mode in the pause menu, where you can customize your arc abilities. If you switch blueprints there, you can create a different kind of weapon.
Your controller flashed red.
That's fine.
Okay. Really? Do their abilities change or something?
They're made with the same debris, so there's no difference between their performance. It's just like switching your fashion. You want to change your mood. But just give it a try.
Fashion? I always wear the same clothes.
Let's see here. Where's that arc ability?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, so this is what it normally looks like. I now have the pixel blade.
Oh my gosh. That's funny.
This blade maintains its sharpness by forming the edges as thin as possible with micro-sized voxels. So now if I have that equipped, the blade is actually just a that's great.
It's just
it doesn't change anything about the actual
blade.
It doesn't change anything about the quality of the sword. It literally just is
changes the appearance.
Yeah. Well, that was a cool little puzzle to solve for, I guess.
I forgot this guy's gonna be back. Fuck this guy.
Yeah, fuck this guy. Mowdy.
Cool, which way are we going?
I suppose we can head back to,
this
point.
Place? Cool.
Let's warp to the beacon so we can continue the story.
What is it?
Well, I was thinking. It's fine about you trying to destroy this place up if you want, But if so, there's one thing which makes it difficult. Sooner or later, you have to face the Astra classes.
The Astra class?
First, about these robots. They seem to call themselves Ajits. The Ajits, a society system similar to feudalism, and this industrial area is one of their fiefs. Each of these fiefs are owned by a high-class Ajits, who are ranked in the Astra class.
Like feudal lords?
That's right.
And one of them are here as well.
I was monitoring some of those communications and found out that one is ruling the area, called the Astra Venate. But I couldn't decipher everything, so I don't know about its abilities and so on.
The Astra Venate, right. The fuck is... It looks so pitiful.
Yeah, they look really weird, don't they? Oh, I'm missing one gate.
I never really saw pitiful that they looked.
Let's see here.
It
there's one
to
more.
To your left, or to your right, where that pitiful looking thing is. It just face slammed. Oh, never mind. The door was open. Whoa, what's that? Looks like a waterfall.
That's a type of resin. We call it elastic fluid. It's harmless, but it has some strange characteristics. It makes chemical reactions with nanomachines, makes them bounce off of them. Maybe I should name a debris ball covered with this a rubber ball.
Make a ball! That looks disgusting.
Please tell me I can. Yeah!
Yes! That is amazing.
Whoa, that thing is big. Damn, he deals a lot of damage.
He does. That's always lovely.
Can I recall the rubber ball?
Maybe, you can try.
After picking it up.
See if you can recall it while you're in midair.
That's what I was gonna try. Yep.
Oh, but it's not rubber.
I'm fine with that, because I can destroy this guy now.
Yes. Be good. Yay. Yeah. That was safe.
Why? Why, computer? Why?
You do this. Oh god, that scared the hell out of me.
Come on, computer. Why is Game Grumps sound like a full blast?
Oh, I thought somebody had broken into your house or something, and I was like, there is no Carter here.
So you know how my computer goes off whenever there's like supposed to be an alarm or anything, right?
Yeah.
It turns itself back on to do so, and if there was a video playing whenever I closed it, it'll continue playing that.
Oh my gosh. Great.
Bloodsteel Arsenal Labor Member. Class Gadahara. Or Gadadhara. Carries a giant hammer, incomparable in size and power.
I'm paying attention.
Class Gadadhara, built with a brain so tiny, lacks intelligence to cover his body.
Okay.
Why does it rhyme at the very end every time?
I don't know. Let's go over what we have. Elastic fluid that has power to bounce off other objects. If I can fly up by jumping on top of it, I bet it's the same if I bump into it from the side.
Hmm.
I'm ready. I'm interested in what she's doing. I want to know where she's going with this.
I don't know. Oh, I know where she's going with this. I know exactly where she's going with this. You see where I'm going with this now?
I see where you're going with this now.
Yes!
That's so cool!
That's awesome!
Dude!
I fucking love puzzle games.
When we get back, if we go back down to that door, we have to look at what's to the right of it.
Huh?
There's more level to the right of the other door. Because isn't there a lower door?
This thing down here?
Yeah. Ooh! Yep!
I wonder if there was a way to, like, goo this and then shoot it up if I didn't have enough energy to kill him.
Yeah.
The old-fashioned way. Oh, wait.
What?
I may have just killed myself with this ball. Yeah, I think if I go up there with the bouncy ball, it bounces me straight into the
thing. Yeah.
So I had to, like, recall it to make it not, bouncy. Nice progress, girl. You're doing good with those, with the arc abilities.
Why, yes. Thanks to you.
You're welcome. You should know that whoever granted such an extensibility your new body, whoever granted such great extensibility to your new body, gotta be an outstanding super genius.
Looks into the camera like The Office. Here we go again. My line was much better.
Well, to be honest, I want to thank you too. The more you fight and use the arcs, the more I collect valuable combat data. Next time I create a cyborg, I'm sure it'll be a much greater work of art.
You're thinking of making another one. Oh, never mind. I thought there was a whole level because it had a block. I was excited for a new level or half the level. Ooh! Colorful.
Yeah,
oh shit, be careful about getting onto that thing. It's gonna run you straight into the damn the fucking spikes.
Yep.
Good night, bitches. Neato.
Oh.
Ooh, that was close. Oh, good. It's not going to fall on you and land and hurt you. Ah! Ooh! Ooh-wee! Oh!
And now I've cleared my path.
Nice. Except you still have to jump over that thing somehow.
Yeah, I'll get to that in a minute or two.
Yeah, you can go over.
Kind of need to get up there. That's my big problem. Let's see here.
Collect more?
Let's restart and see what I can do. Because I need to get to the lock before I do anything else.
You got it!
So if the goal is to get over there... Oops. Hold on. I need to destroy that. Go up. And then
see if you can do it just one side.
Separate from there.
You got it.
And there.
Okay.
Ow. Oh, that thing was alive and pushed me into the spikes.
Shit.
Let's see here. I've got a little bit of ball, so I could break this right here, right?
Mm-hmm.
Trying to think of what's the best use of my motion, though.
See if you can break a little bit. You can break all of that thin. Break all the thin part and see if you can hit these guys right here. Oh, wait. You won't be able to collect it. Never mind. I fucked up.
Well, let's see where this goes. Because I think that might help. And then... If I break right here and right here, I was hoping that would bend a little bit more than. Oh, I'm stuck inside of it. Damn, because I need to get across.
Break that.
Break what?
That down there.
This down here?
Yep, the one that's yellow. Yeah. And recall it. Oh, damn it! Fuck. Maybe that wouldn't work, okay?
You got it! See! Prego! See!
Maybe try just breaking the littlest bottom that you can. Perfect!
Okay. It's the littlest bottom that I can. And then I kind of want to get to right here. And do that.
Perfect. Wonderful.
Yep. No, I think I can collect some of their. I think I collect some of their juices.
Yep.
But I won't be able to carry them through that. Because I'm trying to like eliminate that entire thing there.
Yeah.
Like eliminate that platform, because maybe then I can get the whole thing.
Can you
throw
stuff at it and move it?
I don't think so.
You got it.
Like that. That's what I was trying to do.
You did good. Good
That's
job.
Not quite where I wanted it to go. I can still use this
still
because,
use
let's see here. I can get to this. Oh, and then you know what? I can block. I can block up there. Because I got a really big ball. So that should unlock the big door. And I can lock. Get up here and unlock this door.
Nice.
Now all I gotta do is survive getting back down. Which means not dying to the spikes now.
Doc.
What's up?
Well, I just thought, I don't know about you any much. Like, do you have any other family? You don't look like, so...
No, I don't. Well, I used to.
Oh? I'm sorry.
You had the same experiences as well. It's not that unusual in this world.
I know that, but...
Well, I was a workaholic. My wife was fed up with me anyway. But we had a daughter. If she were still alive, she'd be about your age. Okay, there's no point keeping you out of the loop. I'll be honest about this. Studying their technologies for the development of science, that's not really what I'm in for. Actually, I'm seeking vengeance on the robots. I'm using this as my weapon for this. Wretched old man, bound to the past, using a young girl like you just for self-satisfaction. You could have worded that significantly less creepily.
Right? I was about to say, that sounds really pedophilic.
Go ahead, despise me.
Living to seek vengeance, huh? I'd rather say that's something not unusual in this world. Same with me. I lost many of my beloved people. And I want to make them pay for it, too. First of all, we're on the same boat now. We need to work together to achieve each other's purpose.
Well, well. It would have been easier for me if you just completely hated me there.
Fucking saws.
So see here, I've got saws.
Are you shitting me?
I've got saws, goo. Let's see what all I have. There's a button at the very bottom. Oh, you know what I bet I can do?
What?
Cover this in goo, right?
Uh-huh.
You know what? I was expecting that to go. But that's gonna get chewed up.
Right?
I was expecting the bit of ball that I had to go and push the button.
Yeah.
Apparently that's not going to
happen. Wait, where's the button?
It's
oh,
that thing at the bottom, yeah. Oh, wait. Can't I just...
Fall down.
Oh,
block?
The block is not the button, obviously. Yeah. This block isn't heavy enough.
Huh.
Or maybe I'm just not placing it correctly.
It needs to be in the center, but like...
Let's see here. I'm thinking I need to put that there. See that thing up there?
Yeah.
Ow. Ow.
Might want to restart.
Okay.
We got it.
Oh, I can do this.
Do what?
I can do this to get back up.
Yeah. There we go. Damn. But you got it.
I think? I don't know if I'm solving it the way I'm supposed to. Let's see if that's enough to stop it. Stop it up.
If it's not, you still have your debris.
I do
still have it on top of it.
Yeah. I'm trying to think if there's a way to get it there.
Maybe you do need button block.
No.
Maybe try that one first. See what we can do.
Yeah, I probably should.
Go back up. Do you think there's anything up there that could help? Debris-wise?
I don't think so. Because the thing is, I gotta get over there.
Okay, we'll stand at the top of that block and throw it. See how that works.
Wait, like throw it out?
Just throw it! Just throw it as far as you can. Without, and then recall it later. Oh.
It just drops. Oh, okay. You don't throw it, you just drop it.
Okay.
Now that's instant death if I try to do that. Oops, didn't mean to do that. Oh well.
Oh well.
Doesn't really do anything.
Anything.
Okay, so let's try this. Let's push. Jump. Oh, I was really hoping I could hit that thing from there. There we go. That's
awesome.
That's what I've been trying. Like, every time that I jump, that's what I was trying to do, you know? So we got that one on there now.
Uh-huh.
And then we know for a fact that we just need to do this.
So close.
Let's see here. Well, I know how to get that one now. Let's try to get this one. Damn. There's like no way to get underneath them. Like once you start getting hit, you basically get comboed into death.
Yeah.
It's only luck if you make it back out or not.
Yeah. So we're just gonna have to hope for your best luck. Okay,
like that.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, wait, hold on. I can just, oh, hold on. That's not. There we go. Very slowly run our way along this, because then I have my ball to smack that up and off. And then I can get back up. There we go.
Yay.
Okay, that's all I was trying to do.
Cool.
Damn, was that hard?
Oh, by the way. Things happened one after another, and I completely forgot about it. I haven't ate anything for a long time. When was the last time I actually had a proper meal?
What's up? Worried about your tummy? Of course I haven't forgotten about it, so no need to worry. I made some upgrades to your metabolism, so you can survive through extreme conditions. By diverting the nanomachines, material converting abilities, you can supply nutrition from sunlight, carbon compounds in the atmosphere, and so on. This means you don't need to eat anymore.
Doc, you don't understand a thing. In a hopeless world like this, a humble meal is the only pleasure. Even a moldy cookie or a rusty can of tuna gave me comfort in this desolated world.
Well, is that so? To me, dinner was the thing that I could catch anywhere. Rats, cockroach...
No, no! I can't hear anything! Anything!
I like that you can still see the colors of the individual colors of the things around it.
Yeah.
Like you can tell what the ball is made out of. Like you can tell what debris is inside the ball.
Yeah.
Fernando!
It's so cute. What's she saying?
I don't know.
Say what, bitch?
Japanese.
Say what?
Japanese.
What you say, Ian?
What you say?
Oh, but we don't speak Japanese. Well, of course we don't, cause we're too white. Thankfully, we haven't reached that level of weeaboo. You're welcome. Wasn't it beautiful?
Here. Let's head back to here now. I think
Yeet.
We should.
Cause we gotta go all the way up there.
We gotta go here, and then
wait. Where are we?
We're right here right now.
So then, why don't we just use that door?
Right. Then there's just door right here. I don't know why I was thinking there was gonna be a bit more of a complicated situation to that.
Wait, check the map. I think, okay.
Yeah, I'm right here. Right. I need to head up. Remember, we went down to get here.
Okay.
But I can still head to the right. I haven't head to the right yet.
Getting that big ball.
Yeah.
We got big balls.
At every one of these goddamn doors,
but
almost.
We've got the biggest balls of... Okay, I'm...
Well, shit.
If only I had enough, I could blade my way up there.
Gonna bounce it off?
Yep.
I don't know.
Because I need to have at least a little bit of debris to make a blade.
Right.
I've got a little bit of this I can...
Yeah! Awesome! Go at the spanky.
Hold on. Watch. Are you ready for this?
No, I'm excited though. Bruh!
Smack!
Yes! But now you have to run from that thing. It's horrifying.
Yeah, it's not terrible. See, watch.
Yo!
I honestly thought you were gonna try to go underneath it.
Let's block.
Ah, damn it.
Oh, you know what? I need a rubber ball.
Ah!
Damn, what the
no!
Got fucking comboed.
That was great, though.
That was 100% my fault, too. So get that a little bit gooey. Drop it. Jump. Grab. Slash.
Yep.
Pull in.
Run for your life. Why can't that... Just jump a little closer, buddy. A little closer. Yeah, bitch!
Let's get the ball rubber. Let's get the ball rubbering again.
Yep. Woo! God, that's scary.
Drop it in the hole.
Yeah!
Hey girl, I have something to ask you.
Hmm? What is it?
Well, before the world became like this, do you have any dreams for the future?
Huh? That's out of the blue. Gross?
Well, as a father with a daughter, or used to have a daughter, I was just curious about it.
Nope, not telling you. Also, there's no point talking about it. There's no way to make it happen now.
Hey, what's wrong? It's not what I wanted to hear from a young girl. No dreams could come true if you're giving up from the beginning.
What? You're giving me lectures now? That's so out of your character. You're sounding more weird now.
Imaginations I'm talking about. Think about a bright future. Where those hateful Ajits are eliminated, all our ruined cities built back up. That kind of future. What do you want to do then?
What? Well...
Come on, let me hear it.
I want to be a vet.
Huh?
I like animals.
Oh, I see. That's a pretty dream.
Ugh, forget it. It's none of your business. And first of all, what's this bright future thing anyway? For a cyborg like me, designed for destruction, there won't be a place for me to enjoy a peaceful world.
Aw, just wanted to change the mood there. Looks like that didn't work.
You changed it for...
It's fine for now. Even if there's no hope for the future, anger and sorrow is what keeps you moving, as long as it motivates you to live on.
Whee! The fuck? What was the fucking thing the bird said?
Why is there a gun?
I don't know, but that's fucking horrifying and great.
First off, goodbye. I also love that, fuck you, Jen.
You got it! Oh no, it's you fucking what, mate?
Ahem! You fucking what, mate? Don't. Why?
Because. I am burp. You fucking what, mate? Sorry.
Is that your vape?
Yeah.
You're getting your vape.
I'm missing something. I'm missing a block here. I can't get to this door yet. Oh, you know why?
Why?
I don't think whenever I reset the world that I ever turned that one lock back on.
Damn, it just missed you completely. That's pretty cool.
Let's see here. Yeah, look, I never turned that one back on because I reset the world, remember?
So you bounce the exact same amount with that giant ass ball as you do with the tiny ass ball.
Yep, does not matter its size, just like I make the same size blade no matter the size of the ball.
Interesting. Ah, shit.
Aha, but I regenerated literally just enough health to survive.
Oh, good.
Oh, but I don't have a rubber sword anymore, or,
shit.
Or a rubber ball anymore.
Oh god, I don't like that thing.
Yeah, using the sword causes it to not be gooey anymore.
You just gonna toss it? Fun.
Oops.
Damn it,
I didn't touch that one again. Can I clear any of this junk out?
Apparently not. Did you have to jump over it?
Yeah, I wanted to see if I could clear it up so I wouldn't have to jump every time.
Ah, fuck.
Damn it. I gotta get the jump right if I'm gonna do that.
Just get that cum all over it.
That bouncy cum?
Yeah, that bouncy cum.
There we go.
Who says cum isn't bouncy? Have you ever tried it?
I've never seen it in amounts enough to do that. First of all, I've never seen amounts to do this.
I don't think I ever want to see amounts enough to do that.
Whee! I was not expecting that.
Cool.
Let's go through the door then.
Me too.
You can see the bits and pieces of robot in there too. I love it. So I got a little bit of goo.
I love how it's a perfect bouncy ball once it goes under the cum.
Are you just gonna keep calling it that?
Yeah! I don't remember what it's called! What's it called?
It's like, it's a type of resin that causes. I'm just gonna call it bouncy gel. Let's see here. I need to get up there. This is all for like more cosmetic data as well. Like this doesn't give me anything important.
Yeah.
Let's see here. I'll do
that. Ah no!
Not quite. I wonder if I take this. And then drop it off here. What?
Oh, fuck!
I was not expecting that shit.
That was fucking awesome! Okay. What the shit?
I'm not expecting. Okay. So that shit is not stable in the slightest.
That was awesome!
But how do I get up there now? I guess I just do this now. Oh, the ball doesn't want to.
Come on.
So it doesn't act like the lock where it actually attaches to the surfaces of these things. It just makes them fucking bounce. Like crazy.
That's awesome. Hey, stand on top of it and bounce it.
Oh, you want me to try and see if I can't launch myself using it?
Fucking launch yourself, man.
Come on, I gotta make it rubbery again.
God, I definitely sound like fucking stoner when I'm giving you these ideas. I'm not even drunk.
Yeah, man, fucking bounce it!
Fucking bounce it, man! Fucking bounce it! It's gonna be fucking great.
Since when did being high make you sound British?
I don't fucking know.
You're like,
know.
Just fucking bounce it, mate! Ah, no! Oh, so close!
It would've worked! If
I could have jumped, I could have gotten that. I gotta find out where my stuff is now, though.
That was so cool! I hope it's not gone forever. Oh, no.
I've got a little bit of it. I don't know where the rest of it went.
There it is.
Okay.
That's fucking awesome. Let's just leave that up there. and then get whatever you drop.
There we go.
Awesome.
Let's try it again.
Okay, I'm so fucking excited.
This is such a dumb thing.
This is
such a dumb game mechanic. Why does this have to be a thing?
I don't know, but I love it.
Let's try it again. Are you ready?
So close! Yes!
That's the dumbest way to solve that puzzle.
Best thing ever!
We got the pixel lock. So now we can make the gray lock as a pixel thing.
Do we want to do pixel stuff?
Let's go full pixel now.
Let's
now
do
that we've
it.
Got it.
It'd be cute if we could make her pixel.
You got it!
Like the rest of it great and fancy, but her, just her.
So now I can just go.
Oh, it's cute!
And I have the pixel sword as well.
Sword looks bigger when it's pixelated. Oh my god.
You got it!
Everything's dead.
Oh yeah.
Yeah!
I just heard the fucking gun and I was like, oh god.
There's a large pixel block. Ow. Well, where to go now?
No idea.
Oops. Oh, I accidentally clicked out of the game.
Uh-oh.
I suppose there was another door that I could activate, I think, from this beacon.
Let's do it. Oh, this motherfucker again.
Yeah. Yeah, this door. I haven't gone through this door yet.
Nice.
Because back before I came here, this door only had, I had 3 activated, but I needed 4.
Yeah.
This is a new room now. Fucking hell. This is gonna be fun. No!
Oh, that's fucking cool. What if you can throw your block at it? Yes!
Yep.
I don't think I was supposed to knock the whole thing off like this.
It's best run!
Is there a is there a purple thing over here that I can reset with?
I was like, it's gonna get you! The blocks that's holding it.
Is there a block holding
there
it?
There are 2 blocks that they're holding.
Those are permanent.
Yeah. Then you gotta try to break those blocks. Which I don't know how to get past these guys.
Well, the fact that it keeps fucking spitting out origami explosives at me is really annoying.
Yeah. Huh. We have to hit it back at it.
No, I just need to cut one cable.
There we go.
Let's see, I just need to cut one cable.
Yes!
I just screwed up last time and cut both at the same time.
You were a little close, yeah.
Oops. All right. Big ass bounce ball.
Big ass cum ball.
Alright.
Are you fucking serious? Just throw it down. Just let it bounce on you. Yeah! Quick! Aw, damn. Shit, where are we supposed to be going? Up there. Oh. Okay, but now that we got it going.
You got it!
I need to find my bouncy ball.
Yep. Quickly! Ah!
Why quickly? There's nothing that, like, watch.
I was worried about
watch, watch
Saw!
This. Watch this. You ready?
It's not even gonna break it? Oh, okay. Okay, bye.
Saw blade no longer a problem.
Awesome.
Now you don't have to be stressed
this
about
is
it.
The best game. I think I like this more than Stardew Valley. Alright.
Okay, so let's see here.
I feel like we shouldn't have made it Kami again. I feel like
no,
we
I
need
think
the block.
No.
Oh, okay. Well, okay. Ah, the saw is back.
Ah! Revenge of the Saw Blade! I wasn't expecting it to be inside the fucking ground like that.
That was great. Yep. So much for not worrying about the salt plate anymore.
Honestly, I would have been safer keeping it up in the air.
Yeah.
Let's see here. I think I can make momentum on this thing by doing this. Look.
All right.
See, I'm making it go
this
faster.
It's gonna take a little bit, but all right. Yeah.
They actually did such a good physics engine that you can literally just run back and forth and speed this thing up.
Awesome. Doing a very little bit at a time, but it's doing it. Awesome possum. Ah, shit.
Damn it.
Watch out for the saw.
There it is.
That's so fucking cool. I love the bouncy ball.
Look at big.
The cummy ball.
I'm so close.
Ah, fuck. Oh god, this is
I'm totally gonna do this just by running back and forth. Yes!
Yes!
Fuck your puzzles, I have physics.
That is awesome!
I completed that entire puzzle just by running back and forth over and over again.
Did you save?
Yeah, I don't know, I haven't saved yet.
You haven't?
No.
What happens if you die?
Oh no, I did save.
Okay. Oh, you can't die. Oh shit. Okay.
Oh, I think I know what I'm supposed to do here. So I get up here, right?
Mm-hmm.
Up this, right?
Okay.
Oh, this thing is too heavy for it. Okay.
You needed it to stand up.
Come on. Yeah! Woo! I'm doing these puzzles all wrong and I don't care.
I love it. You gotta get those gems though before you go. You got like four over here and then one in the blue ball.
Breaking these big things takes so much for my green ball.
There's one more.
That's it.
E.
Oh, do I have? I have 8 fucking skill points ready for me.
Nice.
Is that right?
Yep.
Fuck yeah, 8 skill points.
And each of these is only 1 skill point?
Yeah.
That's awesome. Have we read what we're getting?
I'm just picking up everything that has the up arrow on it because those are vitality chips.
Okay.
So I'm like one away from getting another upgrade to my health.
Nice.
That's what I already have. But I unlocked this teleporter now.
See, that part is great. She's so cute.
Uh-oh.
Cutscene?
Boss battle?
Both?
I assume we're about to fight the Astra class. This must be the heart of the construction facility. Nice work, girl. You wrecked this place. I'm sure it'll be a critical damage to their supply lines.
Good. Now all I need to...
So it was you.
Do you want me to do her or do you want to do this?
Bad girl.
I was worried you weren't going to remember this ultra. I'm so happy you did. Hot
damn! Oh, damn. Looks like you are the one who's been messing around and bullying all my adorable dear soldiers.
You're...
This is a sacred place. This is where all the martyrs are cremated, and will be the body of new lives. Slaughtering is such a place. No, that is not good. So I must punish you.
Slaughtering?
You machines think you have the right to speak of life and death like humans. No way. I'm gonna blow this place up, and if you're getting in my way, you're gonna end up the same as well.
Looks like I have to teach you a lesson.
I might have to cosplay one of these girls.
We are Jeet, of the primal species, who have the right to rule this world. You humans are nothing but a futureless race. You can do nothing but to rot away.
I mean, now, yeah.
Astra.
That's cool as hell.
How do I fight her?
Fucking run.
I don't have any debris right now. Can I... Oh, shit, can I... I can't fucking do anything. None of this stuff has any... Wow, I just got my ass handed to me. I don't know how to fight in this game without a ball. And I lose my ball every time I walk in here.
Yeah.
Please, they're gonna make me fucking watch the cutscene again. Oh, no.
Yes, hey.
Oh, nice. We skipped. We gotta skip.
Astra Venata. Okay. I think we might have to hit her when she's crouching. Just punch her.
I think.
See if you can pick up that sword.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, cool. Awesome.
Oh, okay. I see what I need to do now. You counter her sword, break it off, and then.
Shit.
But okay.
Okay,
so
but now we know what we're doing.
I know. Yeah, but this is fucking tough. I know what I need to do now, though. I need to smack her, like, whenever she comes in with her sword, like whenever she like brings it down at me, I need to smack it so her sword flies out of her hand. Her sword is full of nanomachines, and we can spill it on all the shit that she keeps hitting. And her crown is gonna be glowing red until I know I can damage her. Ow,
shit.
Fucking hell. What's supposed to stop that?
I guess you just gotta move. Fuck!
Yeah, I need to. So whenever she throws her sword, I need to hit it.
And dodge everything else.
That's the offline about Astro Vanilla. Really?
Oh, we can't beat her anyway.
She uses her as a tool. Okay, no, it's just telling us, like, if you don't know how to fix it, because the bosses are, whatever. Yeah. Well, the bosses are, like, they're their own puzzles. Like, we had to figure out about the sword and everything.
Yeah.
We could beat her, we just have to actually, you know.
Do it.
Yeah. Let's see here. Dodge that. Jumps again. Swings. Fireballs. Throw sword. Block. Shatter. I don't know how to block that.
Stay away from the walls. It's a pattern. She's just gonna keep doing this, I guess. Okay, she can beat her! Shit.
Oh,
she blows everything away.
She cleared the area after I had hit her.
You just gotta...
I don't know how to dodge that. I guess I have to get around her somehow. Then we get fireballs. Throw sword. Block. Hit. Block. There. Bam! Then she's gonna clear the area again.
Okay.
Slam fireballs.
Stay away from the edge, stay away from the edge.
No, I need to do that. Now I need to stay away from the edge. Okay, I see what I need to do there now. Jump. Up. Slam wall. Fireballs. Lock.
Oh shit. Yes.
What is she doing now? Don't change your pattern now, please don't. Fireballs. Oh shit, there's a lot of them. Oh, I was not okay. Well, I know how to do this a little bit better now.
It's until he powers up. We get this.
Yeah. And even after that, I think I block one sword, block the next. I don't know. We'll have to see how it goes. Fuck, this game is good.
I kind of want to cosplay as both of these girls.
So jump. Jump. Slash. Fireballs. And I can influence where it lands as well.
Really?
Yeah. I don't know. Okay, I don't know how to pass that. I still don't know how to block that. Fireballs. Oh, damn it. I messed that up. Yeah, I don't know how to get away from that attack.
It sucks that, like, she only gives you time to get one hit in.
I really don't know how to stop that. This is called a Giga Wrecker. I'm trying to get underneath her, but I think I have to get over her, but I don't think I can get over her. What are you looking up?
Looking up to see if I can find out what I could do with this bitch. Here we go.
The game's brand new, so I don't think you're gonna find any costumes.
There's some.
Oh, people have already made costumes for this game?
Yeah. Not costumes, I'm talking about walkthroughs.
Oh.
See if I can get any tips.
I wish I knew how to block that. She jumps to the middle and then just slams her sword. Like, there's nothing you can do about it. Oh, shit!
What?
I figured out what I can do.
I have to watch a video?
Yeah, most walkthroughs are videos. I know what I should do now, though. Because there's two chances that I can get her to drop her sword. So I think I can get enough material before her, like, major attack. So let's see here. The jump. Sword. Fireballs, right? So get her sword here. Get her sword here. Get her sword here. Yeah, literally anytime she swings her sword, you can get it. So watch this. Are you ready?
Yep.
So there's that, right? But then there's also... I can get it there as well.
It just didn't let me.
And I can get it here. I have to time it properly. I'm just not good at timing it yet.
You better get good. You got two more bars.
I think I've got it now.
Oh, this is just the listen to music. Never mind.
Yeah, got her.
Yes!
Literally every time she swings her sword, you can combo stop her.
Nice.
How could this be? Giving her a French accent there. How could this be? I'm overwhelmed by an out-of-date, useless creature.
You think that's what they meant? Because out of time doesn't make sense.
Your time's over now.
Okay, sorry. Your time's over now. If I destroy this factory, it should cause a huge damage.
Should cause a huge damage.
Okay. Oh, to all your weapon manufacturer system.
Huh. Our time is over. Oh my. Looks like you humans really don't know a thing. Even if I meet my end here. And this, Samsara, Bloodsteel Arsenal, becomes ruined. The authority and order of the Ajit will stay completely dauntless and solid. As long as our master is alive.
Our master? Here we go.
Hey girl, time to leave. Whole facility's starting to collapse.
Still got a lot of things to ask you, but too bad. I'm out of here.
Now she's defeated, she's trying to take you down together, along with her territory. You are coming with me!
LOL, bye, bitch.
Can we just teleport out of here? Or do I have, like, a timer to run back to the
field? I don't know. Oh, that's cool.
These fucking screenshots are
right. Right?
Phew, that was close. You okay, girl?
Doc, that thing? The Astra Venate was talking about? Some master? Who's this master? Who the hell is it?
Whoa, what's up? You seem to be in such a hurry. Don't ask me. Neither do I know. Neither do I know. The fucking English in this is great.
We're trying so hard! When I fought those things, I found out. They have a stupid plan. They're trying to completely eliminate us and take over our position. Also, they have some kind of a leader who's responsible for all this. And as long as those machines exist, we won't be able to get back a peaceful world again. That weird pausing.
What are you trying to do, girl?
I'm gonna turn them into wreckage. Everyone, everywhere.
Few hours after the fall of Samsara, the Bloodsteel Arsenal.
Be outside. Ugh. Somehow, I managed to get out of the factory. Now I'm completely lost here. Where on earth am I?
Strange. Neither can I locate your position here.
Everything around here is so creepy.
Never know what might happen. Maybe the robot's big boss you've been looking for might suddenly appear. Or maybe I'll just kill a whole bunch of things and collect their bits. Later. Big ball of nasty. Yes, Scott's a jump into that. Okay.
Yeet.
Well,
shit.
Died. I got stun locked.
The fucking combos.
Yeah, we read this. We read this.
At least there's no voice acting. I would be mocking it angrily. Nice.
That was silly. Wait, hold on. Need a little bit more out of the rubble that it created. Not enough.
Yeah, it's about the same size as it was before.
Fucking hell, I can't fucking deal.
So angry.
I think the saws are literally my worst
enemy.
They
are, they really are. Fuck this guy. you, like, sword somebody and kill them?
Not unless I've got the same amount of power as,
Yeah, because that ends up helping just being the same size as it was before you started breaking it up.
Only just barely.
Alright. Better than nothing.
Ah, big enough to kill this thing now.
Nice. Ah! Nice.
Bikoru!
So cute. Bikoru! Are there any Japanese words that don't end in a vowel?
I don't think so. I think it's because if you do like a Japanese to English, every quote-unquote letter is actually like a consonant and letter. Or
yeah,
like a vowel
that makes
and
sense.
Or it's a consonant and vowel or vowel and vowel.
Yeah.
There's no single letters in Japanese. You ready for this?
Yes.
Just have it all.
But sometimes
apart
it
again.
Kind of like explodes almost.
A little bit.
Uh-oh, cutscene.
Ooh. It's the girl!
What's that?
But she got like super corrupted.
Oh shit.
That doesn't look like the Ajit's boss. The human?
Wait! That girl! I know her! I think I want to talk to you. You're that girl, aren't you? The one who saved me from that prison. Girl!
Hey, wait. That's not just her body. It looks like they filled with her brain as well.
No! What have they done? Grow! That's not supposed to be grow, but I couldn't help it. It was funny. Hey, I don't even know your name, but you knew my name, didn't you? It's me, Rika Rikeji. Rika.
She's almost a beast.
Come on, stay with me. You still got it, right? Your mind. Your human mind. Can't any more mind my mind. I can't keep longer. Hurry, please, kill me. No, I can't do it.
No, you don't want to, but look at her. There's no choice but to fight.
Name. My name is Astra Sarame. No. Stop it.
One is created by a human using the Ajit's technology.
God, these
the other is created by the Ajit's using the human's body. Two cyborgs with different origins, making these two things kill each other. What an awful taste those robots have.
It's so weird to go between, like, the deep voice I want to use for her and, like, the high-pitched voice.
Well, you hear it.
Yeah. Oh, shit, she got a car.
This is a boss fight.
But like, what even is she?
No clue.
I want to know this power she's using.
Yeah.
Damn it. Oh, damn, I really hope. Okay.
Okay.
Gotta go through the portal again.
So glad we saved.
Right? And it should just start the fight directly, yeah.
I'm not doing this again.
No.
I'm not gonna scream every time. She'll scream for me. God. It's scary to hear, like, the voice actor screaming along with, like, the garbled screaming.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, God, and I know that's supposed to be creepy like that, but, ah!
Yeah!
The problem with voice acting when you're not using your normal voice is you have to be consistent, and that's really difficult.
That's why you get so many voice actors that nowadays
just use their own.
Yeah, they get famous for having what a lot of people consider same voice now.
Yeah.
But it's just because like same voice is consistent as fuck.
Yeah. It's just like I don't want them all to sound like me.
Mm-hmm.
I want them to be different, and I want to emanate the I can't, that's not the word, but I want to give the characters justice.
Mm-hmm.
I want to use an octave or a tone that's more what I feel the character would actually be. Even though that's not the voice I'm using. I like her Japanese voice, though. But I like her English voice. Mostly because I'm having fun doing it.
Ow, damn it. Damn it!
Shoot it, shoot! So if you don't do it in time, she hits you with those things.
Oh, I didn't.
Shit!
And half the time the debris, like, completely and totally masks where she is.
Yeah.
Because if I hit her with anything, she stops doing her current attack.
Yeah. Do you want me to start calling out if I see her, or...?
I think I got it.
Okay.
I just, like, now that I know the rhythm, like, they all follow a pattern. I just need to actually follow a pattern.
Wonder what her name was before.
Maybe we'll
find
out.
I wonder if once we defeat her, if we can save her.
That'll be interesting. I wonder if they'll make a DLC where you get to play as her.
That would be awesome. I wonder if it's gonna be later in this game.
Maybe. Well, DLC is
downloadable content.
Yeah, it's for like.
So yeah, I hope it is.
It would be the same game, but it would be like, you know, they made
from her
it,
perspective.
Like,
yeah.
But it would also have been made way later.
Yeah.
Like usually, a DLC is noted for being something that was created after the original creation was finished.
Yeah. After a lot of people probably already finished the game.
Yeah. The idea would be like it's content added after the game was finished that they wanted to add in by the way, post processing. Do the fucking arm attacks so I can actually gather something up.
Yes.
And then she's gonna do this. And she's gonna give me 4 attacks per like invisible time.
So is this when time is frozen?
Yeah.
Okay.
Every time she does that, she's freezing time.
Okay. What is she doing?
She's teleporting stuff around.
Oh.
Well, that's what she's doing.
I guess she's trying to confuse you and then hit you.
Yes. Boy. Thank you. What have I done? I just wanted to talk with you and ask you why you were looking for me, why you were trying to kill me. Came all the way here just to know the reason. I busted that chance with my own hands. None of it can be recovered. Hey girl, just leave me alone for now. Might have a chance to try again. I said leave me! Huh? What do you mean? Hey girl, whatever her actual name is, she called herself Astra Samare. Her ability, she must have used an extremely high precision tachyon particle manipulating device. What are you talking about? Listen girl, search her corpse and find that device. Might be able to try again. What? Her corpse? Try again? No kidding. I'm serious. That device, I'll make a machine that'll maximize the tachyon particle's time-distorting characteristics. It'll activate a mass tachyon burst, which will reverse time. You'll be able to change the future, save her from dying. A few days have passed after I gave Doc the tachyon particle manipulator, which I found from Astra Samare's body. Doc then completed a portable tachyon particle manipulating device, the Tachyon Handler. I'll use this to cause a time reverse and go back in time. She hasn't died yet. The girl whose name I don't even know. So this is the Tachyon Handler. Change in the future and humans' destiny. What will happen from now on is beyond the boundaries of science. Even I can't guess the results. But I'm sure you'll do well. Yeah. Thanks, Doc. My pleasure. So say hello to me in the past. Got it. Okay, let's go! What's wrong, girl? Really turn back time? Anything wrong with your body? Did I adjust some of your machine parts? Doc, the weapons factory. It's not right. Aren't there any bases? Come on, tell me. Huh? How do you know that? I haven't even told you about the robot's weapon factory. What's up with you? I didn't do that much remodeling with your brain. Maybe you've gone crazy after the operation. Of course not. I used it, the tachyon handler. Maximize the tachyon particle's time-distorting characteristics with your machine. Activate a massive tachyon burst. Right? Hey. How come you know about that, girl? Did you actually use it? You really alright? But, wait. So it might be. Girl? So you really turned back time. Now, just a few seconds, or a few minutes, a few hours, or even a few days? Right. Just as I expected, Doc. You understand the situation so fast. I already have the concept in my head. Just having difficulty miniaturizing the device itself. So somehow, completed in the future. Even if it is a diversion of the Ajit's technology, this proves that I am such a genius. Though it'll take much more time for him to understand. He's more obedient than I thought.
Ian, want some water while I'm up?
Me?
Yes.
Sure.
Cut back there?
Not here. Just get a cup from the cabinet.
Okay.
Anyway. So you said the factory's not the right target. As I wasted time there, the girl who helped me was turned into a cyborg by those things. To a cyborg, eh? Let's see. If that's so, let's leave the factory from our choice, then. How about here? The Ajis Research Laboratory. But there's less information about this place, so the risk will be higher. I don't care! Going there. Well, I think we're going to make it a little bit of a shorter stream today. Normally we would go 3 hours, but I think I'm going to cut it off right about now because I'm making homemade calzones, and those take a minute or two to make. So roughly an hour from now when the dough is ready and we're cooking it, you and I are both going to be starving, and we're going to thank me for cutting it off a little bit early today.
Okay.
Sorry. By the way,
I liked this game.
By the way, we went back in time.
We went back in time? What the fuck did I miss?
So we killed the girl, found out that she had that what she was doing was time manipulation, took this very, very precise tachyon particle that she had, put it into a device that the doctor made. The doctor then sent us back in time to before we went into the factory, and now we're going to a different location to try and see if we can't save her before she gets turned into a cyborg.
Awesome! That's wonderful!
And that's where we're going to end it today.
Aww.
So,
But I can't be here on Thursday unless you stream early.
How early? Because we can set up an early stream.
I have to go to work at 4:30.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That would be considerably early.
Yeah.
Hmm.
I mean, I could be here for part of it, unless you just wanted to do it normal.
I might just do it normal, because whenever you said, like, early, I was thinking, you know, maybe a couple... Yeah,
three.
Yeah, but not, like, morning
noon.
Early, yeah.
Oh, well.
Well, I think we've got plenty of this game left to go through.
Yeah.
So we'll have plenty of fun with that. But yeah. I've been Paladin Null. This has been CPQ.
Hi.
This has been Giga Wrecker.
Game
by Game Freak, of all people. I was not expecting that to come out, especially not one to come out on a game to come out on PC, of all things.
Yeah.
And it's really fucking good.
Are there multiple save files?
There are.
I'm going to download this. I'm also going to download Undertale. Play that unless you want me to play it on stream.
Doesn't matter to me. You can play however you want.
Okay.
But anyway, hope you guys are having a fantastic day. My outro has been messed up for a while now. I hope you guys are having a fantastic day. I've been Paladin Null. This has been CPQ. This has been Giga Wrecker. And as always, I'll see you guys later. Bye bye.